And welcome to McKelvey Park for game two of the second part of the doubleheader. This game features Larson's Bracers, the 4-4 Larson's Bracers versus the 4-4 Independent Order of Odd Fellows. I'm Joel Goldschmidt, glad to be with you here tonight as we are just about to get underway. This will break the tie between these two teams in the standings, and one will move ahead into the fourth position, which is the last playoff spot, and one will fall farther behind with more ground to gain. And leading off for the Larson's Bracers is Gabe Martinez, who's also the pitcher. Unusual starting batting position for a pitcher, but this is Little League, so anything goes. Babe Ruth baseball. And pitching for the Independent Order of Odd Fellows is Kyle Morrison. And here we are for the first pitch, and it is just inside for ball one. Morrison with a very good fastball there on the first pitch, too fast for the catcher to handle as it got back to the backstop. And Martinez is ahead 1-0. And the 1-0 pitch from Morrison is fastball high and swung through by Martinez, and it's 1-1. Lively fastball from Morrison, as we will expect to see a lot of that tonight. And the 1-1 delivery from Morrison is right down the middle, strike two. Caught looking on that one was Martinez as he falls behind 1-2. He's got to look for something to put in play here. And the 1-2 pitch is a curveball, and backing away from the pitch is Martinez. He manages to foul it off to the right, and the count will remain at 1-2. And the 1-2 pitch again is swung on and missed, strike three. Another good fastball from Morrison to send Martinez back to the dugout and bring up Dino Bravo, the left fielder for the Larson's Bracers. Dino Bravo is standing very close to the plate, crowding it a little bit, and the curveball is right over the middle for a strike. 0-1 the count. Bravo standing in, waiting for the delivery, and it's inside fastball. It's fouled back to the backstop, and it's 0-2. Morrison's working very quickly here, working the fastball and the curveball to take advantage of the count early in the game. Oh, and two the count, and Morrison winds, and the delivery is a curveball over the middle, a strike three, swung through by Dino Bravo, and Morrison is 2-for-2 in the strikeout ratio here, as he goes for the strikeout of the inning against Mike Muria, the catcher for Larson's Bracers. And Morrison's delivery, curveball on the outside part of the plate for strike one. The 0-1 delivery is bounced back to the backstop, 0-2. This is a very impressive showing so far for Morrison as he's mixed speeds and locations very well to confuse the hitters. It's recording the first two strikeouts and getting ahead 0-2 on Maria. The 0-2 delivery from Morrison. Fastball fouled off to the left. Well, out of play over all the spectators here tonight. As Coach Cunningham looks on for his Independent Order of Odd Fellows. As 0-2 pitches, fouled back to the backstop. That was a curveball off the plate. Might have been a ball, but we'll never know because he fouled it away. And Morrison winds. And the pitch, fastball outside, swung through and missed. The ball gets back behind the catcher. He runs the first, and he's going to be safe. That is going to be ruled a strikeout and a pass ball. So Morrison does have three strikeouts on the inning and could go for a fourth. Next up for Larson's will be Will Evanson. He's the shortstop for this team. As Maria takes his lead off first, Morrison will be working from the stretch now. And he steps off and throws to first. Back with plenty of time is Maria. And Morrison at the set. Throws, he's runners off. Curveball out for a strike. And Maria's going to be in standing at second with a stolen base. And the count is 0-1 for Evanson with the runner in scoring position. Morrison looks back at second, delivers to the plate, fastball over the plate, is fouled back, 0-2. And Morrison looks back at second and delivers to the plate, and it's fouled back again. Remains 0-2. Not to jinx him here, but Morrison has only thrown one ball this entire inning, which is quite remarkable. And as he's going for his fourth strikeout, not something you see very much. Morrison delivers, grounded to first. Easily played by Scherff, and he takes him into the bag and records the out to end the inning. And as we play the half of the inning, it's 0-0. As we are ready to start the bottom of the first inning, starting lineups for Independent Order of Oddfellows. Leading off and playing center field is Josh Gabriel. Batting second and playing shortstop is James Perez. Pitcher's batting third and Kyle Morrison. Batting cleanup, the first baseman, Brian Sherrill. Third baseman is batting fifth, Paul Hurt. Left fielder batting sixth is Jose Andretti. And batting seventh, playing second base, is Robbie Welsh. Batting eighth, the right fielder is Xavier Keelan. And the catcher is batting ninth, and Tyler Gloskell. As we look at the defensive alignment for Larson's, we can see that Gabe Martinez is the pitcher, and he is winding and delivering to Josh Gabriel, and the pitch is outside for ball one. And Gabriel, the 1-0 pitch, throws. That's popped up to second base, and out to get that is Welsh, that's Taylor rather, and he records the unassisted put out. So one down, and Perez steps to the plate, try to get some offense going here. So left-hander steps in, the pitch. Hit down the left side, giving way is Hubbard, and it's going to fall foul. And Martinez delivers outside, ball one, and the count runs to 1-1. Perez waits for the pitch. Pitch is fouled back, and it's 1-2. Martinez winds, throws a high fastball swung through for strike three, and Perez is retired for out number two. Which brings up the pitcher for Ayoub, Kyle Morrison, worked very well in the first inning on the mound. Gets to face his counterpart in Gabe Martinez. As Martinez winds and throws way outside, past the catcher to the backstop for ball one. And Martinez winds again, delivers outside part of the plate for strike one. 1-1 the count. And the 1-1 pitch is fouled off to the right side. We're in the count to 1-2. Bounces back into play. But still foul for 1-2. Looking to close out the inning is Gabe Martinez. And Martinez with the 1-2 count, throws, and Morrison swings and misses. Ball bounces away. Picked up and easily thrown at first by Maria, and that retires the side. Three up, three down, as we go to the top of, as we end the first inning. Never mind, I believe that was tipped, barely, and it remains 1-2. Fooled me. Fooled all the Larson's players as they all tried off the field. And we try this again. 1-2 to Morrison. And everyone's back into their proper positions. And Martinez winds and delivers. Curveball in the dirt. Ball two. 2-2. As he gets a fresh one from the umpire. Martinez winds and throws, curveball, and that hit him. Hit him in the back. So Morrison takes first base on the intent, on the hit by pitch. And that brings up Brian Sherrill, who's the first baseman for Ayoub. Looks to try to bring in Morrison from first base. And the coach has come out to talk with Martinez for a brief minute, and he's back on the mound, ready to go. And we're waiting for the umpire, fixing some of his gear. And he's all ready to go. And two outs, runner on first base for Sherrill. Martinez working from the stretch. Delivers. Line into right center field. That's going to fall in there into the gap. And rounding second is Morrison, heading for third. Picked up by the center fielder Gabriel, or Jones, and Morrison's coming to the plate. There's a play at the plate, and he is out. Tagged out by Maria, and that ends the inning on the 8-4-3 put out. As we see on the replay, driven into right center field. Knocked down and picked up. Dropped again. Throws to the second baseman. The relay throw back home. Good blocking of the plate by Maria, and tagged out is Morrison. So we go to the top of the second inning. Tied at zero. And we see some of the people here watching the game. Family, friends, fans. As we see the standings of the Babe Ruth League. Ayoub and Larson's fighting it out for fourth place. One of them will be all alone in fourth place at the end of the game. As game one of this saw Colonial take a fall. And they drop down to 6-3. So this game does mean a lot here as Morrison is ready to pitch. And he delivers fastball outside for ball one. Mike Bernal stepping in, first baseman for Larson's. As Morrison winds again and delivers. Driven to second base on the bounce. Wells picks it up, throws out at first base, and one's down. Nice play by Welsh, picking it up, getting over there, throwing him out at first base to start the inning off right for Ayuf. This brings up Ian Jones, center fielder for Larson's. And Morrison works from the left side of the rubber, winds, and delivers. Inside, fouled back. 0-1 the count. So that pitch was coming very far inside. Would have been a close call for hit by pitch, but he fouled it off anyway. And runs the count to 0-1. Morrison delivers. Curveball, strike, swing. 0-2 the count. See a nice curveball break into the outside part of the plate. And Morrison works from the delivery and throws inside, nearly hit him. Ball one gets away from the catcher. And it's 1-2. And Jones standing in. Looks at the offer from Morrison. Curveball, low and away. 2-2. Good eye to lay off of that one as that was coming right towards the middle of the plate before it broke away. 2-2 the count. And Morrison winds and throws inside. Ball three. Full count here, as Jones has done a good job of laying off the last three. And the count is full. And here comes the payoff pitch from Morrison, and it is high fastball swung through for strike three. Four strike out of the evening for Morrison, which brings up Aaron Hubbard, the third baseman. And Morrison winds and throws, low and inside for ball one. As Hubbard waits, Morrison winds and throws over the plate and popped up, but looks like this one will be out of play for strike one. 1-1 the count to Hubbard. And came right back here. And Morrison throws, and there's a shot up the middle. Fielded by Perez, throws over to first, just in time to beat Hubbard to the base, and that ends the inning. As we've played 1.5, and the score remains scoreless. As we're back for the bottom of the second inning, and the first pitch is fouled off to the right by Paul Hurt, the third baseman for Ayuf. And the count's 1-0. Martinez winds and throws, curveball, breaks in there for strike two, 0-2, and Hurt is quickly behind. And the 0-2 delivery from Martinez is grounded to first base and bobbled, but picked up and put out by Bernal over there at first base, and Hurt is retired for the first out of the inning, which brings up Jose Andrade, who is the left fielder for Ayuf. And he steps in there with one out, and the delivery by Martinez is up and away, ball one. And Andrade quickly ahead, stands in there, pitches right down the middle for strike one, and evens the count up at one. And the 1-1 delivery, strike two. 1-2 the count, as the last two have been fastballs down the middle. The 1-2 delivery from Martinez, fouled off to the right and just out of the reach of Bernal. Count remains 1-2. And the 1-2 delivery is high and away. Curveball got away from Martinez on that one. 2-2 the count. And the 2-2 pitch is outside and a little low, and that runs the count to 3-2. Full count here to Andrade. And Martinez winds and throws. Fastball, strike three. Swing and a miss. Two down in the second inning as Larson throws it around. Robert Walsh is stepping in. Robbie Walsh, I apologize, as steps in with two down and the pitch. And that first pitch is in there for a strike, so the 0-1 delivery is another strike on the outside part of the plate, 0-2. And Martinez looking to end this inning quickly. Winds, throws, strike three. Struck him out swinging, and that ends the second inning as the score remains scoreless. And stepping in for Larson's is Leon Taylor, and he steps back and takes that one inside. Ball one. Taylor is the second baseman. It's a wonderful moonshot there by Robin on our great camera crew. And delivery from Morrison is inside, part of the plate for strike one, as Taylor offered for bunting on the second pitch. And Morrison winds, delivers, inside, swung at, strike two, 1-2 this count. Taylor going for the high sock look. And Morrison winds, throws, high fastball, gets away from the catcher. Runs count 2-2. And Taylor waiting for the 2-2 pitch from Morrison, and it is strike three. Low part of the plate, called strike three. That's Morrison's fifth on the evening. And that brings up Kirvin Smith. And Morrison winds, throws, inside for ball one. Smith waits, the delivery. High, ball two, 2-0. And Morrison sets, throws, strike one, 2-1 the count. That fastball is right over the middle. And 2-1 pitch from Morrison. Fastball on the inside half of the plate, called strike two. 2-2 is the count. And Morrison winds, throws, outside, ball three. And Smith goes down to first base, so he's gonna have to come all the way back. Finish off the bat. Almost got the referees, umpires on that one, but he brings them back. And the 3-2 pitch is right down the middle, strike three. Sixth strikeout for Morrison as he is finished with the lineup one time through, as this brings up Gabe Martinez in the top of the lineup. And two down in the top of the third as Morrison throws. Curveball swung at, strike one. 0-1 the count. It's a nasty curveball Morrison's got working tonight. Starts off going right down the middle of the plate and breaks way off into the batter's box. And Morrison winds, throws, fastball lined right back the box, up the middle into center field for a base hit. Good solid contact from Martinez as that's the first base runner of the night besides the pass balls on the strike three. And that brings up Dino Bravo with two outs and a guy on. And Martinez takes his lead off at first, gets back in time for the throw over from Morrison. Morrison looking over at Martinez at first, delivers, the runner's going, curveball over the middle of the plate, and Martinez is going to have this one stolen. Standing up as the throw comes in way late, and now there's a runner in scoring position with one out, with two outs, rather. Bravo stepping in. Waiting for Morrison. And he delivers. Curveball up and away. Ball two. And the count is 2-0 to Dino Bravo, looking for something to drive in Martinez, and he swings at an inside fastball for strike one. And ball is dead as the pitch got away from the catcher of Ayuf, so Martinez will have to return to second base.
Not a foul ball, you hit him with the backswing.
Two and one the count as Morrison working from the stretch now with the runner on. Looks back at Martinez and offers towards the plate. Curveball over the middle, strike two. 2-2 is the count. Bravo. Waiting for the pitch. Curveball, inside part of the plate, strike three. That ends the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors. One man left on base as we go to the bottom of the third. Remain scoreless. As we enter the bottom of the third inning, Xavier Keelan steps in for Ayuf, and the pitcher Martinez is grounded to shortstop, picked up by Evanston, and throws to first in the dirt. Picked out very nicely by Bernal of Larson and retires Keelan for the first out of the inning. It was a great scoop by Bernal over there at first base as that throw over skipped way in front of him. So it wasn't the easier short hop, it was the in-between hop that is so hard to handle. But he handled it very nicely and retires the first batter of the inning. And the first pitch from Martinez is out of the strike zone for ball one. Batter is Tyler Gloskell, the catcher for Ayuf, and Martinez looks, winds, throws. That's popped up towards the second baseman. Welsh underneath it and corrals it for the second out of the inning. That's two down. The lineup card will turn over for the top of the lineup and Josh Gabriel. As Martinez has recorded two very quick outs as bottom of the Ayuf lineup has been free swinging. The first pitch, chopped down the third baseline, trickling, fielded, nope, kicked, and he will reach on the infield hit. as Hubbard could not corral that one, and even if he did, I don't think he would have had enough time to throw over there and get him out at first. So Gabriel reaches on the infield single, and that brings up James Perez. And wind up the pitch, he's running and he's fouled away. And out of play. Hubbard could not get over there. Ran out of room. And Gabriel will return to first and the count is 0-1. And Martinez working from the stretch. Looks over and throws over. Try to get Gabriel leaning. But he's back in time. Count remains 0-1. And the 0-1 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed. Strike two. 0-2 to Perez. Two outs. And Martinez. Looks in and throws, and the runner's going. Fastball's outside. Throw down to second is not in time as Gabriel has this one stolen. And that's the second stolen base of the game, first by Ayoub. And now there's a runner in scoring position with two outs. 1-2 is the count. Perez waiting. Throw. Chopped to first base, brought in by Bernal, runs over to first to record the third out of the inning, and that now we've played three, and the score is scoreless. As we head to the top of the fourth inning, or as we like to call it at KMVT, the Jim O'Malley inning, we take a look at the snack bar, perhaps the best snack bar in the world, or at least in the peninsula. I recommend their hot dogs, they are quite excellent. And leading off for Larson's is Mike Maria, the catcher. As he waits. And a throw by Morrison is a curveball in there for a strike. 0-1 the count to Maria. And Morrison winds, throws, swung on and missed, 0-2. That pitch was in the dirt. Fairly unhittable. And Morrison winds. The 0-2 pitch. Bounced to shortstop. Fielded by Perez. Throws over to first just in time. And that's the first out of the inning for Morrison. Perez had no time to waste on that play as he fielded it and threw over in one motion to just get the speedy runner. And the cleanup spot is up right now and Will Evanson as Morrison winds and throws. Curveball, strike one. It was a nasty one as he had Evanson leaning back and it broke right over the plate. And Morrison winds, throws. Another curveball, except he was waiting for that one as he lines it into left center field and cut off very nicely by Andrade as he throws it into the cutoff man and holds him to a single. As Morrison got him the first time on the curveball, Evanson was waiting for it on that one as he lines it right over the shortstop's head, but great play by Andrade to cut that one off, prevent him from taking extra bases. But for the first time today, we have a runner on with less than two outs. So this could be the start of a rally. You never know. As this brings up Mike Bernal, first baseman, as he throws over to first base, back in plenty of time as Evanson. As they throw over again. And Bernal waiting. Morrison throws over a third time. Hopping back to the base. This time was Evanson, but still in plenty of time. And Morrison from the stretch throws over the fourth time. Still safe is Evanson. Morrison delivers to the plate. The runner's going. Curveball in there for a strike, but this one is going to be stolen easily. As Evanson had a great jump on that play. It's almost at second base by the time the catcher had time to throw the ball. And now there's runner in scoring position with less than two outs. A couple of opportunities for Larson's to bring him in. And the pitch is grounded to the hole in second base and through into right field. Rounding third and coming in as the right fielder boots it a little bit and scoring on the play is Evanson, driven in by Bernal. And we have broken the scoreless tie. Now it's 1-0 in favor of Larson's. As a second baseman was over covering second base for the pickoff play, couldn't get back quite in time to field the play, and in to score is Evanson. So one out and runner on first base, 1-0 Larson's. Bernal takes his lead off first as Jones steps into the box. Morrison throws over to first base again. And Morrison throws, strike, fastball right down the middle, swung through. Very lively fastball. Couldn't quite catch up to that one, was Jones. And it's 0-1. And the 0-1 pitch is low and outside for ball one. Evening the count up at one. And the runner takes its lead off at first, and Morrison throws, and it's fouled off of the catcher into the backstop, pushing the count to 1-2. As Jones looks down at the third base coach to get his signals, steps back in, and Morrison throws over to first, quick toss. Back safely, though, is Bernal. Minor disagreement from the fans out there.
Hey, we have hope, man.
Morrison from the stretch delivers. The runner is going. Curveball over for strike two, or strike three rather, but in safely on second base is Bernal. So strike him out, but stolen second base, and there is a runner at second with two outs. That's the third stolen base for Larson's tonight. And the second one this inning. It's the first one helps put the first run of the game on the board. And this brings up Aaron Hubbard. And Morrison winds and throws. Ball low. Another fastball from Morrison. And the third baseman waits. Morrison delivers. Swung on and missed. Strike one. 1-1 to count. Morrison takes a look back at Bruno at second. Now goes back to the plate, and the ball is chopped shortstop, fielded, and thrown to first base in time for the 6-3 putout. And that retires Hubbard for the second time tonight. And we go to the bottom half of the fourth inning. It's 1-0 Larsons. As we've reached the halfway point in this game, go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Leading off for IUF is pitcher Kyle Morrison. And Martinez winds and throws in the dirt for ball one. Morrison was hit by a pitch in the first inning, ended up not stealing second, but was running on the play when Cheryl hit a ball into right center field, but was eventually thrown out at home. And that has been the best scoring chance for IUF, as the 1-0 pitch is outside. Ball two, 2-0 is the count for Morrison. And Martinez winds, throws, low in the dirt, ball three, 3-0 is the count. Morrison might have the take sign here. And Martinez winds, throws, right down the middle. Take sign was on, and it's 3-1 now. And Martinez winds, throws, and it's hit hard into right field, but right at the right fielder, and fielded on a knee by Smith, and that's the first out of the inning. That ball was hit pretty hard, but unfortunately for IUF, it was hit right to the right fielder, and he was easily retired. This brings up Brian Sherrill, first baseman for IUF. 1-for-1 on the day with a single in the first inning, as the first pitch is outside for ball one. And Martinez winds, throws, hit back up the middle, and Cheryl is 2-for-2. So he's got a pair of singles today. He has figured out Martinez. And there's a man on with one out. This brings up Paul Hurt, the third baseman. He led off the second inning with a ground ball to the first baseman. And Hurt, Martinez throws over to first base, back in plenty of time as Cheryl. Martinez working from the stretch. Delivers, swung on a miss, strike one. Martinez quickly ahead 0-1. Cheryl takes his lead from first. Martinez throws over there, back standing. And Martinez throws, curveball, swung on and missed. Fooled him badly on that one. Hurt managed to get off a late swing, but could not make contact with the ball, and the count is now 0-2. Martinez winds, throws, curveball, hit back up the middle, fielded by Martinez, throws shortstop for one, onto first, in the dirt and gets away. And he will stay at first, but the out is recorded at second base as Hurt reaches on a fielder's choice. So there's two outs, the man on. And this brings up Jose Andrade. And Martinez throws, and the ball is grounded at first base and a great fielding play. And out at first base by a step is Andrade, as Bernal makes an outstanding sliding play, gets him out at first base to end the inning. So, no runs on one hit, no errors, one man left on base, and we head to the fifth inning, 1-0. As we start the top of the fifth inning, first pitch from Morrison is low in the dirt, ball one. And count 1-0. Morrison Wines throws. Strike on the outside part of the plate. Looks like they've made some changes. This is Jared Hetrick batting now for Robbie Welsh. And that pitch is way inside. And I apologize for that one. I was looking at the wrong scorecard. That is my fault, and this is Deion Taylor. No substitutions has been made. I apologize for that one.
Come on, get aggressive, batter. Come on, you can do it.
And Morrison Wines throws low and outside. That runs the count to 2-2. And Morrison Wines throws low in the dirt. And Taylor walks, and that will start off the Larson's inning. The leadoff runner. We'll see if they look to steal here, as they have every time they've gotten a runner on so far today, so we'll keep an eye on Taylor over there at first base. And Morrison throws. Runner's not going, but that one's over for a strike. Kirvin Smith is standing in for Larson's, trying to move Taylor along. And Morrison throws as he looks to bunt, and he pops it up towards the dugout, and that's out of play. 0-2 the count. Morrison's working from the stretch. Delivers. Ball's up. 1-2 is the count to Smith. Morrison deals, throws, strike three, swinging. That's his ninth strikeout of the evening, as this goes to the top of the lineup and Gabe Martinez. Martinez is 1-for-2 with a strikeout and a single. Morrison throws, strike over the outside part of the plate, as that pitch had a lot of movement on it. Fastball, catching the outside part of the plate, 0-1's the count. Martinez getting the signals from the third base coach, steps back in, see if something's on with the runner. And he is off, and the pitch swung on and missed. Throw down to second, is in time, and the tag is in time, and he's caught stealing. Good throw by the catcher, Gloskell, as he catches Welsh stealing, or Taylor stealing, rather. As we see here, getting up throwing on one hop to the base, and a good tag by the shortstop, Perez. 0-2 the count. And Martinez throws, chopped to the third base side, into field it, is hurt, throws over to first, but not in time as Martinez beats it out, gets his second hit of the evening. This brings up Dino Bravo. Martinez is taking a lengthy lead off of first base. Morrison looks over there, and he's off. The pitch is outside, and the throw down to second is not in time as he has this one stolen standing up. Fourth stolen base on the evening for Larsons with one caught stealing. So 1-0 the count to Dino Bravo. And the pitch from Morrison. Curveball low. Ball two. Bravo ahead in the count. Looking for a good pitch to hit. Morrison looks back at second. Throws. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Blew that one right past Bravo. Morrison working from the stretch, throws, over the plate, strike, swing. Quickly evens the count back up at 2-2. Two outs. Runner on second. Morrison throws, swung on and missed. Ball gets past the catcher. Bravo goes to first. The throw to first is just in time to end the inning. And on the inning, that's no runs on two hits, no errors, one man left on base, and we head to the bottom of the fifth inning, still 1-0 Larsons. And in the bottom of the fifth inning, the lower third of the lineup heading up for Ayoof. They try to get on the scoreboard against Martinez, who has been outstanding tonight, limiting them to three hits, no runs. And Martinez throws, swung on and missed, strike one. Robbie Welsh is the batter, swung through that first one. Welsh is 0-1 with the strikeout against Martinez tonight. And Martinez throws, fastball, swung on and missed, strike two. And the 0-2 pitch, swung on and missed, strike three. Three pitches, three strikes, one out. Springs up, Xavier Keelan. And the first pitch from Martinez is fouled back over the backstop. Strike one. 0-1 the count to Keelan. Martinez winds, throws, low in the dirt, ball one. One pitch from Martinez, thrown over the plate and fouled back by Keelan, and the count runs to 1-2. Martinez, 1-2 pitch, throws high and inside. Keelan had to duck under that one. Counts even at 2-2. Martinez winds, throws, curveball, too low in the dirt. Full count. And Keelan looks in, and the pitch is grounded to shortstop. It runs to first base. Evanson throws in time to get Keelan at first for the second out of the inning. Second 6-3 put out for Keelan this evening. This brings up Tyler Glaskell, the catcher. And Martinez looks in, throws, low and away for ball one. Glasgow heading the count early. And Martinez throws, fastball over the plate. Popped up to second base, under it and making the catch. It's Welsh, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Ayuf. And that ends the fifth inning, and we'll head to the sixth. Score is still 1-0 Larsons. As we enter the sixth inning, Morrison still on the hill for Ayuf. He is dealing and throws, and that pitch is fouled away by Mura, the catcher for Larson. We have a few changes for Ayuf. Jacob DeWitt entering in right field, replacing Xavier Keeland, who actually moves to second base, spelling Robbie Welsh. So those changes for Ayuf, as Larson maintain the 1-0 lead. Squaring to bunt as Mura fouls it back, quickly 0-2. Also for Larson, Mike Medlock coming into the game, placing Kirbin Smith for all those of you who are scoring at home. Morrison winds, throws, the pitch is hammered to the right side of the infield. Nice backhand stop, throws to first, and just in time to get the speedy Mura. Great play by Bernal, who threw it over, or by Cheryl, who threw it over to Morrison to replay him, to retire him. Hit hard into the hole. Good diving play. Flipping it over to Morrison, getting his foot down just in time. Get the first out of the inning. This brings up Will Evanson for Larson's. As Morrison winds, throws. Fastball over the outside part of the plate. Strike one. Evanson is 1-for-2. He's got a single, a stolen base, the only run of the game. He's also grounded out to first base. The 0-1 pitch, curveball, ground to third. Booted and kicked to shortstop. Not in time to throw it over. Well, throws it over, not in time. And he's got a second hit of the game. We'll see what the official scoring on that one is. Could be an error, could be a hit. Regardless, Evanson's at first base. And I've just been given word that an error was given on the play to the third baseman. The first one of the game. And Bernal is now up for Larson's as Evanson takes his lead. Morrison throws. He's off and running. It's going to be no throw on this one as he had that one stolen off of the jump. Up the fifth stolen base for Larson's. Second one for Evanson. And Morrison working. One out, throws, Bernal swings and misses. That brings the count to 1-1 for Bernal. Morrison takes a look back a second, delivers, the runner is going, grounded in the hole at shortstop. Nice play by Perez, throws over to first, just in time, the runner's coming home, the throw of the plate is not in time. As a great play by Evanson to speed around the bases and score another run. That brings the score to 2-0. Just good hustle by Evanson, never stopping as he rounds the base, thinking going home the whole time. Didn't even have to get his uniform dirty on that one as he had that one standing. This brings up Ian Jones, and Morrison delivers the first pitch strike. Two outs here in the top of the sixth inning. Morrison with nobody on, works on the windup, winds, throws, swing and a foul tip into the glove, and the count is 0-2. Morrison Wines throws, swung on a miss, strike three to end the inning. But the damage is done as they add another run to their total. That brings the count to 2-0 Larson. And leading off the bottom of the sixth inning for IUF is Josh Gabriel. Gabriel's 1-for-2 with a single, stolen base, and a ground out. Waits for the offering from Martinez. So that one on the outer half of the plate. Catches the corner. Strike one. Martinez winds, throws. The 0-1 pitch is way outside for ball one. Counts even. And Martinez winds, throws, and that ball is chopped off the plate and foul. Staying alive is Gabriel, or not staying alive, but run the count to 1-2 instead. And Gabriel waits. Curveball is a little too high. Counts even at 2. And the pitch from Martinez is outside and low, but swung at, and strike three. And Gabriel's retired for the second time tonight, which brings up James Perez. Perez is 0-for-2 with a strikeout and a ground out. Looks to improve his luck a third time around. And that pitch is popped up to the third baseman, and Hubbard puts it away for the second out of the inning. One pitch, one out. And with two outs in the inning, this brings up the pitcher, Kyle Morrison. Morrison 0-for-1 with a hit-by-pitch and a fly out to right field. And Martinez winds, throws, outside, ball one. As we see, Morrison taking strike one, evening the count at 1-1. And that pitch was outside, ball two. And Martinez winds, throws, foul back, 2-2. Martinez winds, throws, curveball, grounded down the third baseline, but just foul. Count remains 2-2. And 2-2 is the count. Morrison waiting. Martinez winds, throws. In the dirt, low and away. Full count with two outs here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Morrison's looking to get something going for his offense. Martinez winds, throws, and that one has popped up on the infield. Coming in to field it and putting him away for the end of the inning is Larson's. So no runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on base. We're heading to the last inning. 2-0 Larson's. And to start off the seventh inning for Larson's is Aaron Hubbard, the third baseman. We have a new pitcher for IUF. As you see, the first pitch is popped up and foul out of play. New pitcher is Anthony Figueroa, replacing Kyle Morrison, who now moves behind home plate. Morrison's line score on the evening is 6 innings pitched, 4 hits, 1 walk, 2 runs, but only one of them was earned. He had 10 strikeouts on the evening. And Figueroa winds, throws to Hubbard, And that one's lined into left field. Base hit. As Hubbard reaches base for the first time today.
That's the one we threw out last game.
So Deion Taylor comes up now for Larson's with Hubbard on first base. Figueroa working from the stretch now, throws over to first base. Back in plenty of time is Hubbard. And Figueroa deals, squares to bunt as Taylor puts it down in front of the plate. Only plays to first base. Figueroa throws, and plenty of time for Taylor. But advancing on the play is Hubbard. So getting the job done is Taylor. Moving the runner over into scoring position with one out. Bringing up Mike Medlock, who replaced Kirby Smith after the fifth inning. So Medlock waits. Figueroa from the stretch, throws high, aimed at his head, ducks out of the way of that one. It's just a ball. Ball one. And Figueroa looks back at second base. Deals, throws, that one's fouled right back. 1-1 is the count. Medlock looks in. Figueroa deals, throws, bounce back to Figueroa, throws to first base. Might have had a play at the runner going to third base because Hubbard did advance. If Figueroa looked over at him, he could have had a chance to throw him out at third, but instead electing to take the easy out at first. Again, the second out of the inning. Lineup card turns over for the third time. Gabe Martinez comes to the plate. He is 2-for-3. A couple of singles, a stolen base, and a strikeout. So Hubbard now at third. Figueroa looks, throws, strike down the middle. 0-1 the count. Figueroa looks at the runner, throws, off-speed pitch is popped up towards shortstop. Going back, and coming in is the center fielder, Gabriel, making the play, ending the inning, and will send this game to the bottom of the seventh inning, where Ayoub will try to come back from a 2-0 deficit. And in the bottom of the seventh inning, Ayoub will have their 4, 5, 6 batters coming up, Brian Sherrill, Paul Hurt, and Jose Andrade. Sherrill is 2-for-2, two singles, see if he can lead off this inning with a hit. So that one goes right down the middle. As Martinez has been excellent tonight, only allowing 3 hits, no runs. Martinez winds, the 0-1 pitch is outside, ball one. Down 2-0, Ayoub needs runners more than anything right now, as they will get one, as Sherrill has his third hit of the game, his third single. The ball gets past the center fielder, but backs up and getting it, and throwing it back in, holding him to a single. So Ayoub has the needed runners as the tying run comes to the plate. Paul Hurt, the third baseman, stepping in. And Martinez winds, throws, low and outside, ball one. Hurt reached base in the fourth inning on a fielder's choice and bounced out to first base in the second inning. Martinez throws, and Hurt takes ball two, low and inside. Martinez throws, high, ball three. as Martinez is getting himself in a little bit of a hole here. 3-0 the count. Hurt can be very selective with this pitch. And the pitch, inside part of the plate, strike one. 3-1's the count. Sherrill takes his lead off of first. Martinez throws. Hurt bounces this one to shortstop. It's hit slowly. Sherrill's going to second, forced out there. There will be no play at first base. So for the second time tonight, he hits into a forced play as Sherrill is eliminated at second. Hurt reaches base. And with one out, Jose Andrade steps up. Andrade's 0 for 2 tonight. See, he looks back at Martinez, who throws outside ball one. Hurt takes his lead off at first. Andrade looks back. Martinez throws. Ball outside. 2-0. So Martinez falls behind for the second straight batter. Martinez looks, throws, in the dirt, ball three. So second straight batter, he's gone 3-0. We'll see if he can bounce back like he did last batter. And Martinez throws. Andrade looks at ball one, taking all the way. Just trying to get some runners on here, Zayuf. Martinez from the stretch. Delivers. In the dirt. Ball four. Now Ayuf. It's two guys on with one out. The winning run's at the plate. Tying run's at first base. This brings up Jacob DeWitt, who replaced Robbie Welsh, in I think the fifth inning. As Larson's is having a conference on the mound as to strategy, if they possibly put down a sacrifice bunt, whether they're going to try to go to third or just get the easy out at first. As the huddle breaks, Martinez returns to the mound. And DeWitt steps into the box. One out, bottom of the seventh inning. The corners are pinched in case of a bunt. Martinez throws, high and inside, ball one. Martinez might be losing his control a little bit in this inning, as he's fallen behind the last two batters, including walking Andrade. And DeWitt takes ball two, low and inside. Martinez has lost a little bit of his velocity too. So we'll see if that plays a factor as the game progresses. As we're having a minor disagreement between the umpire and the coaches of Larson's, that is quickly settled, and we resume to play. Martinez looks in, throws, in the dirt, ball three. And the runners are advancing, and he is going to be out at third as Hurt. And that is a big base running mistake there. On the 2-0 pitch very low and in the dirt. Really not a whole lot to gain by advancing here. 3-0 pitch, it's high, and he walked him. So the bases would have been loaded, but instead there's two outs and runners on second and first and second. And Xavier Keelan now steps up as the last chance for Ayuf. And the pitch, it's right down the middle. Strike one. And Martinez looks in, throws, fouled back. And now it's 0-2 to Keeland, and last strike. Now the pitch, outside, ball one. So Keelan needing to get something going here, get on base or otherwise, and looks in for Martinez. The pitch popped up. Will it stay in play? Catcher going back, and it's just out of play as it hits off of the bleachers. Murrah gave chase for that one, but could not corral it. And the count remains 1-2. DeWitt leads off of first, Andrade off of second. Keelan looks back at Martinez. Martinez looks in, gets a signal, throws, pitches high, evens the count at 2-2. Martinez working from the stretch, throws, down the middle, is fouled off. Keelan staying alive for another pitch. Martinez trying to complete this game all by himself. Throw the complete game shutout. Throws to Keelan. Pitch is high and inside. Full count, 3-2. That could be big because now the runners will be off on the pitch. A ball hit into the gap could score DeWitt from first. Could tie the game up. As the infielders will call a conference for themselves. So with the count 3-2 and two outs, the runners will be off on the pitch. Could prove to be crucial, depending on where the ball is hit. Martinez looks in from the stretch. Keeland looks, and the ball is low and inside, ball four. And the bases are juiced. This brings up Nelson Figueroa. And he has a chance to tie the game with a single here. If there weren't any base running mistakes this inning, there would be a run-in with the bases still loaded. But there was, and so Figueroa steps in, takes the first pitch for a strike. Keelan, the winning run at first, DeWitt the tying run at second. Figueroa looks in, swings and misses, strike two. So 0-2. Figueroa looking to just get the bat and the ball. Martinez winds, throws, outside just barely. The count is 1-2. Anthony Figueroa looking back at Martinez. Martinez winds, throws, fouled off just barely. Count remains 1-2. Base is full of odd fellows. And Martinez throws. Pitch is lined to second base, but right at the second baseman, who throws on to first base to end the game. And that ends the game in the seventh inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, three men left on base. And winning pitcher was Gabe Martinez through seven strong innings, holding the shutout. Four hitter in the works. Three-hitter, I'm sorry. As this ends the nightcap of the doubleheader, IU falls to 4-5 in league play. Larson's improves to 5-4, maintaining the fourth spot in the league all by themselves. And that'll do us from McKelvey Park. Thank you for watching. Thanks to our cameramen, Rob and Frank, and Brent Stone. Thanks, as always, to Laz, producer, director, and everything else. Special thanks to Mountain View Babe Ruth League for their support and cooperation. I'm Joel Goldschmidt. Thanks for joining us.